So good afternoon once again, boys. In our yesterday's class, we completed some of the compounds of our second year group elements. So in that category, the last variety is nitrates. After nitrates, we will discuss about that is the diagonal relationship of that beryllium with aluminium. Anomalous properties, some compounds of magnesium and calcium. This is the remaining syllabus, boys. So today we are going up to compounds of magnesium. Compounds of magnesium. Okay. So right now I'm starting here. Nitrates. Very, very important topics are there, boys. Yes. So that is nitrates. What is this nitrates? How to prepare? What is the importance of these nitrates? See here. So nitrates, boys. So what is the general formula for nitrates? Our second year group element has plus 2 oxygen states. Nitrate, NO3 minus, the combination is MNO3 twice. It is the general formula for nitrates. It is the general formula for nitrates. Now, what is the preparation of these nitrates? What is the preparation of these nitrates? So see here, preparation methods, boys. Preparation methods. This is a salt. So when acid and base combination gives salt, boys, like that, different methods of preparation. That is any metal oxide and reacts with, so you want nitrate, there is a corresponding acid, that is HNO3A. So metal oxide when reacts with HNO3, 2 moles HNO3, that gives metal nitrate plus H2O is the productant. So metal oxide with HNO3 gives metal nitrate. Next, similarly, metal hydroxide reacts with HNO3, gives metal nitrate plus water, boys. Metal nitrate plus water. Similarly, metal carbonate, this is also basic in nature. This reacts with, so once again, HNO3, that gives metal nitrate plus H2O plus CO2 are the products. Plus H2O and CO2 are the products. So this is the way to prepare these metal nitrates. So these are the salts of acids and bases. So no doubt, these are all basic compounds. These are acids. So the nitrate corresponding acid, that is HNO3. So this is the way to prepare these nitrates. So first of all, this is the preparation of nitrates, boys. Okay, now, so these nitrates are generally extracted from, crystallized from their aqueous solutions. So when these nitrates are crystallized from their aqueous solutions, so see here, so next point, that is, so when crystallized from aqueous solutions, see here, that is magnesium nitrate. Magnesium nitrate gives hydrated salt, boys. Very, very important. Magnesium nitrate gives hydrated salt because there is hydrated crystalline salt. What is the formula? MgSO4 6H2O is the product, boys. Hydrated salt is coming out, magnesium sulfate. If barium nitrate is there, barium nitrate, if it is, this is crystallized from there, its aqueous solution, anhydrous salt is formed. Anhydrous salt without water molecules formed. That is BaSO4 is the product, boys. So no water of crystallization. Here 6 water molecules in crystallized form. But here, no water of crystallization, anhydrous salt is formed. So, barium nitrate, magnesium nitrate, yes, thank you, boy. Magnesium nitrate with water, that is magnesium nitrate is formed. So, but barium nitrate, this is BaNO3 twice. Anhydrous barium nitrate is coming out. Paisa, because top to bottom metals, that is hydration agent, decreases. Because that reason, so no doubt barium has least hydrating power. So almost anhydrous salts are coming out from nitrates. Next, very, very important, that is, I'm trying make beryllium. That is, if beryllium any, so beryllium salt, not only beryllium, beryllium salt, if it reacts with N2O4N, very, very important pointer. N2O4, it is a dinitrogen tetroxide. Dinitrogen tetroxide, which is in liquid state. Liquid N2O4, that gives corresponding nitrates and also basic nitrate. Beryllium nitrate is a final product. Basic beryllium nitrate. So that is basic beryllium nitrate is the final component. Basic beryllium nitrate. See here what happened. So that is beryllium chloride, BeCl2. When it reacts with liquid N2O4, that gives beryllium nitrate with N2O4 addition compound. This is further, that is vacuum and N2O4, that is liquid N2O4, that gives respective beryllium nitrate is the productant. Beryllium nitrate. If it is heated up to 125 degrees centigrade. If it is heated up to 125 degrees centigrade, that is Be4ONO3, six times a compound is formed by us. Be4ONO3, six times component. This is called as basic beryllium nitrate. This is basic beryllium nitrate. So that is along with nitrate, basic beryllium nitrate is the final product. So this basic beryllium nitrate is very, very important in your advanced point of view, boys. What is its structure? What is the information from that structure? We will learn. Please hear. So this is very, very important. That means when liquid N2O4, liquid dinitrogen tetroxide, reacts with beryllium salt, so that gives respect to nitrate. Along with that nitrate, basic beryllium nitrate is the final structure. Basic. Now, what is this structure? What is the information we should gather from that structure? Now, I'm trying to draw the structure of this basic beryllium nitrate, boys. So, please try to draw along with me. Basic beryllium nitrate. What is its formula? That is basic beryllium nitrate. Formula Be4ONO3 six times. Be4ONO3 six times. Now it's a structure wise, four beryllium atoms are there. These four beryllium atoms arranged themselves tetrahedrally. See here. Beryllium. These are the four beryllium atoms, boys, arranged tetrahedrally. So now I'm drawing tetrahedral picture. These are not bonds, boys. Just I am representing. This is a tetrahedral structure. These are the sides of tetrahedral voice, these dotted lines. 6 sides. So that means all beryllium, 4 beryllium atoms arranged tetrahedrally. Okay. Now, 6 NO3 minus ions are there, nitride ions. These 6 NO3 minus ions existing as a bridge between beryllium atoms. See here, NO3. This is NO3 boys. So along the sides, existing bridge, that is NO4. It is NO3 boys. So this one NO3 between these two beryllium atoms. Next, one more NO3. Third one. Fourth one. So fourth one. Now fifth one. Between these two, fifth one boys. Between these two, I'm representing here. Between these two. Next, between these two. These are six and six NO3 minus ions existing as a bridge that gives a bridge structure, boys. See here, what is that? So oxygen connected with beryllium with a covalent bond, Here also covalent. It is all covalent compound, boys. The basic beryllium nitride is a covalent compound. So now, between these two. So this is the bridge, boys. So every nitro group, NO3 group, NO3 minus ion, acts as a bridge between two beryllium atoms. Total six. Now one oxygen is there. That oxygen atom, basic oxygen, is exactly in the middle of this tetrahedron. See here. This is the oxygen, boys. Exactly middle of that tetrahedron. So that is bonded like this. Four beryllium. So this is the structure of basic beryllium nitrate, boys. From this information, what we have to gather? From this structure, the gathering information is, so see here, first point. From that structure, all the beryllium are in tetrahedral. Four beryllium atoms form a regular tetrahedron. Four beryllium atoms form a regular tetrahedron. Okay, next point. Six NO3 minus ions. Six NO3 minus ions acts as a bridge between beryllium atoms along six sides of tetrahedron. So these NO3, 6 NO3 minus ions gives a bridge. Next. Third point. That is oxygen. About that oxygen. The basic oxygen. Is at the center of tetrahedron. Next voice. See here, every NO2, NO3- ion gives two bonds. So it is one bond, it is one bonded. Every NO3- ion gives two bonds. That means, so if it is axis ligand, that gives two bonds, that's why it is a bidentate ligand. So see here, next point. So here, NO3- ion acts as a bidentate ligand. Here NO3- ion acts as a bidentate ligand. So this is the information that is extracted from this structure boys. So this is very, very, very important. This is very, very, very important boys. So it is a basic. So basic beryllium nitrate. Basic beryllium nitrate. Boys, six edges. Yes, yes. This is edge. Along this edge, this is access the bridge. Along this edge, this is bridge. Along this is the bridge. Okay? So we feel like that. Okay? So this is very, very, very important. Number of times in advanced level, based on this, number of bits are coming out. Very, very important. Next. So it is a covalent compound, no doubt. Similar structure is also possible. Similar structure, note point. Similar structure. Also possible with basic beryllium acetate or carboxylate. Basic beryllium carboxylate, that is nothing but so Be4O. I'm taking acetate COO 6 times. So this is the example, boys. Carboxylate, it is the example. So here nitrate ions are replaced with acetate ions. So that means, so it is now replaced with CH3. Sorry. It is now replaced with C. It is CH3COO. Like this, CH3COO. So every nitro group is replaced with this CH3COO. CH3COO. So similar structure is possible. That means, how many bridge nitro groups are there? 6 bridge nitro groups are there. Nitrate ions. 6 bridge nitro. Similarly here, 6 acetate ions acts as a bridge. 6. Everything is same. Here just NO3 is replaced with CH3COO- or RCOO- or means any alkyl group. RCOO-. So this is very, very, very important, boys. It is very, very, very important. Okay? So now, what are the properties of these nitrates? So their stability, yes. So their stability and also solubility. Stability and solubility. See here. Okay, now some of the properties of these nitrates. If these nitrates are strong heating, thermal decomposed. If metal nitrate is on heating, gives respect to metal oxide and NO2 gas and O2 gas similar to sulfates was. Already explained, so that is a metal sulfate, it is on heating gives metal oxide plus SO2 gas and O2 gas. Like this, here SO2 gas is released, here NO2 gas is released. It is a sulfate, that is nitrate. So that means most of the properties are having similarities. Nitrates properties are similar to sulfate properties. Not only thermal decomposition, and also in their stability and solubility also. stability and solubility of these nitrates follows both carbonates and sulfates. And see here now, thermal stability of nitrates follows sulfates. What we know, so sulfates thermal stability top to bottom increases. Here also nitrates thermal stability top to bottom increases. And that means, so that is increases from top to bottom. Increases from top to bottom. Thermal stability increases from top to bottom. So what is that? That is beryllium nitrate less stable than magnesium nitrate, less stable than calcium nitrate, less stable than strontium nitrate, less stable than barium nitrate. So this is the order of stability, boys. Very, very, very important. It follows both sulfates and carbonates. Sulfates and carbonates. Similar stability is possible. Next. That is the solubility also. Solubility also follows sulfates and carbonates. That is, decreases from top to bottom. So decreases from top to bottom. Solubility decreases from top to bottom. But very, very, very important. But all nitrates are soluble in water. But all nitrates soluble in water, but the solubility top to bottom decreases. But sulfates, barium sulfate, that is the last component which is not soluble in water. But here, barium nitrate also soluble any, but less soluble. So now the order is beryllium nitrate is more soluble than magnesium nitrate, more soluble than calcium nitrate, more than strontium nitrate, more than barium nitrate. Everyone soluble, boys, but that solubility decreases from top to bottom. Everyone soluble, but the solubility decreases from top to bottom. So this is about some of the properties and preparation methods of these nitrates, boys. So this is the end of salts of our second A group elements, general compounds of our second A group elements. So this is very, very, very important. So please keep in mind, these are the, this is the stability order, this is the solubility order for nitrates. Stability order, solubility order for nitrate. Okay. So this is general compounds, boys. This is general compounds. Now we are going towards what is the anomalous properties of beryllium, because every first element in the group, every group first element, not follows rest of the elements. So because of some conditions, so that means the first element behaves differently when compared to other elements, other same group elements. So that property is called as anomalous property. Here also the first element is beryllium. Beryllium properties are entirely different from rest of the same group element properties. So that is why that is also called as anomalous properties. Now our topic is anomalous properties of beryllium. So please take somebody. That is anomalous properties of beryllium. So already we explained it in our first A group elements. So there lithium has anomalous properties because that is the first element. So similar condition, because of similar reasons, here also beryllium properties are different from the same group elements, other group elements, same other elements. Same group, other elements. Those properties are called as anomalous properties. See here. Anomalous properties of beryllium. Anomalous properties of beryllium. Sir, why beryllium differently behaves from the rest of the same group elements? Because it has some conditions. Already I explained at the time of lithium. Here also same conditions, boys. See here, beryllium. Its atomic number is 4N. its electronic configuration 1s2 2s2 1s2 2s2. It is the outermost orbit. Outermost orbit contains 2p orbitals. It has no there is no electrons, but 2d orbitals are not exist. 2d orbitals are not exist. Based on these reasons, see here, it is outermost orbit. Outermost orbit contains only 2 electrons. It is inner orbit boys. It is penultimate shell. Penultimate shell contains only 2 electrons, but remaining elements have 8 electrons. Penultimate shell more than 2 electrons, but here contains only 2 electrons. See here, what is the reason for this one? Reason for this one, first one, small size, no doubt. Beryllium has a small size. Because of the small size, so second one, high nuclear charge density. So because of small size, more nuclear charge is available on in the outermost orbit. Because of that, high nuclear charge density is available. So next, third point. Third point, high electronegativity. Because of small size, electronegativity of beryllium is more than that of rest of the same group elements. So rest of the elements which are present in the same group, high electronegativity. High electronegativity. Next, fourth point. What is that? See here, it is a penultimate shell. Penultimate shell contains only 2 electrons. Only 2 electrons. Penultimate shell contains only 2 electrons. Next, fifth point, that is outermost orbit shell not having any d orbitals. So outermost shell contains no d orbitals, boys. Not having any d orbitals. 2d orbitals are not exist, but remaining elements have outermost d orbitals. Because of these reasons, these 5 reasons, the properties of beryllium is entirely different from same group next other elements, and same group other elements. Now what are those? Give some examples. I'm giving some examples, boys. See here, first point, what is that? So beryllium, so beryllium compounds are covalent. Beryllium compounds are covalent. Yes, not contains, not having any d orbitals. That means the outermost orbit doesn't have any d orbitals. No d orbitals. Okay, beryllium compounds are covalent because of small size. Due to small size and high nuclear charge. So because of small size and high nuclear charge, beryllium compounds are very, very covalent. But remaining element compounds are mostly ionic. But beryllium compounds are covalent. Next, second point. Okay, that is beryllium with cold water. No reaction, boys. Already we know. But other elements can react with that water. But other elements can react with water. So, but beryllium not reacts with water. Next, third one, that is, so it is the least reducing agent. It is the least reducing agent as it has high SRP values. SRP means standard reduction potential, boys. Reducing power is inversely proportional to SRP value. In this group, SRP of beryllium. In this group, SRP of beryllium. Yes. SRP of beryllium is high, so therefore reducing property is very, very poor. But other elements are good reducing. But beryllium is least reducing agent. SRP means standard reduction potential. Next, fourth point, that is, so beryllium with acids not release hydrogen gas. Beryllium Yes, yes, Sudan. Beryllium with acids doesn't liberate hydrogen gas, but rest of the elements, when reacts with acids, liberates hydrogen gas, but not beryllium, but not beryllium. Okay, so next, Nelakanda, please wait. At last, please ask. I will clarify your doubts. So beryllium with acids not liberates hydrogen gas. Next, fifth point, that is beryllium hydride, BeH2, is covalent. Beryllium hydride is covalent and polymeric in nature. We know the polymeric structure. So, but other hydrides are mostly ionic. Mostly ionic. Okay. Next. Beryllium with hydrogen. Direct reaction. Not possible. Beryllium with hydrogen. Direct. There is no direct reaction between beryllium and hydrogen. Please take at the time of hydrate formation. So beryllium with hydrogen direct reaction not possible. There is another way. Beryllium chloride reacts with LiAlH4. Hydrates are formed anyway. So direct reaction of beryllium with hydrogen is not possible. So it is also a special property of our beryllium. And it is anomalous property of beryllium. Next. So observe these properties also. See here. Next one, boys. That is seventh one. Beryllium carbide, Be2C. Beryllium carbide with water liberates methane gas. And that's why it is a methanide. It is a methanide. Carbides of other metals gives ethylene gas. That's why those are called as acetylides. But beryllium is methanide. Okay, next point, that is beryllium with alkali liberates hydrogen gas. See here, when beryllium reacts with NaOH, gives Na2BeO2, sodium beryllate, and hydrogen gas is liberated. But not others. This type of reaction is not possible for others, boys. Doesn't liberate any hydrogen gas with alkali. It is also anomalous property, boys. Next, ninth point. So that is beryllium nitrate is covalent and volatile. But others, nitrides, are ionic in nature. So beryllium nitrate itself, it is covalent and volatile. Volatile means easy to evaporate. Next. Next point, boys, that is beryllium has more complex forming ability, but others almost very negligible percentage. So beryllium forms complexes easily because of small size and more charge. See here, beryllium BeH2O 4 times 2+ ion. So that is beryllium F4, 2- ion, beryllium OH4, 2- ion. Respect to complex compounds are possible, but others almost not possible. but others almost not possible. Next point. Solids. BeCl2 has polymeric structure. Solid BeCl2. Already we know. Yesterday we completed it. So solid BeCl2 is a polymeric structure. So vapor phase, dimer or monomer. So here, so solid BeCl2 is polymeric structure, but the others not polymeric structure. Next. BeOra, beryllium oxide, amphoteric end, but not others. But others are basic oxides, boys. But beryllium oxide is amphoteric end. Next, BeO has, it has urzite structure ending. That is ZnSra, urzite structure. Here, coordination number of beryllium is equal to 4. Coordination number of oxygen is equal to 4. Therefore, it is a 4:4 type crystalline. So, beryllium oxide is, it has urzite-like structure and 4:4 type crystalline. But others have NaCl-like structure. Here, coordination number of metal is equal to 6 and coordination number of oxygen is equal to 6. It is 6:6 type crystalline. So these are all some special properties only exhibited by beryllium, not by others. So all these are considered as anomalous properties of beryllium. Very, very, very important points, guys. Very important points. So BeO has urzite, ZnS-like structure, and others have NaCl-like structure. So that is FCC structure. NaCl-like means FCC-like structure. Coordination number of both have 4 and 0. That is 4 and 4. It is 6 and 6. It is a 4:4 type crystal. It is 6:6 type crystal. Okay. So this is the way to explain anomalous properties of beryllium. But that means beryllium properties not coincided with same group next elements. But its properties are coincided with next group, that is the 13th group, second element, that is the second element, aluminium. So that is called as diagonal relationship, boys. Now we are discussing about diagonal properties, diagonal relationship between beryllium and aluminium. See here. So next topic. That is, diagonal relationship between beryllium and aluminium. So diagonal relationship between beryllium and aluminium, that means the properties of beryllium is almost are equal to properties of aluminium. Why, sir? What is the reason behind it? Already we know, right? So, reason for this one. So, both beryllium and aluminium have same size. So, both beryllium and aluminium have same size. And both have same polarizing power. Both have same polarizing power. What is polarizing power? That is charge to radius ratio. This charge to radius ratio is called as polarizing power. So that polarizing power is the same for both beryllium and magnesium. Beryllium and aluminium. So that means almost the same. Because of these two reasons, the properties of beryllium is almost or equal to properties of aluminium. Now, what are the similarities between beryllium and aluminium? Let us observe some properties. So now, what are those properties? What are the examples for this one? That is the first one. So first one, that is oxidation potentials. Of both beryllium and aluminium are nearly same. Oxidation potential means when beryllium changes to Be plus 2, it is oxidation wise by the loss of electrons. Some potential difference existing between this and this. So that is ion and its metal. So that is called as oxidation potential. That oxidation potential here also aluminium. Al plus 3 plus 2 electrons. Okay. So here E, beryllium to Be plus 2, some potential is there, is almost all equal to. So E, potential of aluminium to Al plus 3. So because it is oxidation takes place, so that oxidation potential is almost all same. That oxidation potential of both of these are almost, yes, 3 electrons, boys. Yes. Oxidation potential almost same. Because of this, automatically properties are same. Next, second point, that is polarizing power, automatically same voice. Because of that, both have same extent of polarizing power. That is compounds of Be plus 2 and Al plus 3 are almost equally covalent nature due to their polarizing power are nearly same. Because the polarizing power nearly same, so both the compounds are equally almost covalent character is almost the same. Compounds have same covalent nature. Okay, next, third point. So beryllium and aluminium with concentrated HNO3 rendered passive. Boys, yesterday with the reaction with acids, with concentration of the beryllium is a passive. That is what I told in day before yesterday or yesterday. Rendered passive means initially there is a slight reactivity is there, but after that the reactivity goes on decreasing. That is finally goes to zero. That behavior is also applicable for aluminium. So that is why both beryllium and aluminium with the concentrated HNO3 rendered passive nature is possible. So that is the similarity, boys. Next, that is both beryllium and aluminium not reacts with water. Both beryllium and aluminium with water, no reaction, boys. Already beryllium side we know. So tomorrow, day after tomorrow, I will start 13th group elements wise. So there we will discuss once again. So aluminium also with water, no reaction wise. Because of formation of thin oxide layer due to the formation of protective oxide layer. Due to the formation of protective oxide layer, almost these have no reactivity with water, boys. With water, no reactivity. Next. That is sixth one. Beryllium carbide, Be2C, with water gives CH4 as a gas. Similarly, Al4C3 with water gives methane gas. So beryllium carbide when dissolved in water gives methane. Aluminium carbide when dissolved in water gives methane. That means both these are methanides. So it is a similarity between both beryllium and aluminium, boys. Both beryllium and aluminium, it is a similarity. Next, seventh one, beryllium with alkali, NaOH, liberates hydrogen gas. What is that? Na2BeO2 plus H2. It is a sodium beryllate and liberates hydrogen gas, boys. Similarly, aluminium, when reacts with NaOH, in the presence of water gives NaAlO2 and liberates hydrogen gas. So it is sodium metaaluminate and liberates hydrogen gas. That means both beryllium and aluminium with alkali liberates hydrogen gas. With alkali liberates hydrogen gas. So it is also similarity between beryllium and aluminium. Next point, that is beryllium nitrate, Be3N2, when dissolved in water, that gives respective hydroxide and ammonia gas is evolved. Ammonia gas. Similarly, aluminium nitrate, ALN, when dissolved in water, gives aluminium hydroxide and ammonia gas is evolved. That means both the nitrides with water liberates ammonia gas. Liberates ammonia gas. Once again, the similarity. Next, BeO, beryllium oxide, and Al2O3 are amphoteric in nature. Both these are amphoteric. Already we know beryllium oxide is amphoteric. Al2O3 also amphoteric, boys, and it dissolves in both acids and bases. And dissolve both acids and bases. So those are soluble in both acids and bases because these two are amphoteric. It is a similarity, boys. It is the similarity. Okay. Next point. So beryllium chloride, BeCl2, has a bridge structure. Similarly, AlCl3 also has a bridge structure. Beryllium chloride has a bridge structure. Yes, that means both the halide compounds are bridge structures. And see here, so this is beryllium chloride. Yesterday we know this is BeCl2. I am drawing dimer state, boys. So it is BeCl2 structure and dimeric structure. But AlCl3 like this, aluminium Cl 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 AlCl3, one more AlCl3. So it gives this one. It gives this one. So both the beryllium AlCl3, it is not AlCl3, boys, it is represented as Al2Cl6, it is dimer. So it is also dimer, boys. So both have bridge structures. Both have bridge structures. So it is the similarity, boys. Next, 11th point. Beryllium form complexes like BeH2O 4 times 2 plus BeF4 2 minus BeOH 4 times. So 2 minus. This is the complex formation, boys. It is the complex formation. Similar to beryllium, aluminium can also form complexes, boys. So aluminium, this gives Al. Al, water with 6. It is coordination number 6, boys. That is a 3 plus. That is Al, F6, 3 minus. AlOH 6 times, 3 minus. Similar complex compounds are also possible. That means the complex forming ability for both beryllium and aluminium almost the same. That means all these properties gives the information about the similarity between beryllium and aluminium. That means both beryllium and aluminium properties are almost coincident. That is, this relationship is called as diagonal relationship, because those two elements in your periodic table are available in diagonal way. So that's why the relationship is called as diagonal relationship. Diagonal relationship. So this is about diagonal relationship between both beryllium and aluminium boys. Both beryllium and aluminium. So this is the diagonal relationship. Okay. So these are all some properties, some general properties. So no flame color. Yes. No flame color. Correct, boys. Okay. These are all some general concepts towards your, that is second year group elements, that is alkaline earth metals. Now we are in compounds of particular elements. In our syllabus, we have compounds of both calcium and magnesium. Both calcium and magnesium. So today we are going to cover compounds of magnesium. Tomorrow we will discuss calcium. Okay. Now compounds of magnesium. Compounds of magnesium. Compounds of magnesium. In this category, almost we have 6 compounds, boys. Almost very, very less content is there. So we will discuss all these 6 compounds. See here. First one, magnesium oxide formula. Mg1, magnesium oxides Mg1. See, boys, for every compound preparation methods, some of its properties and uses. We must cover preparation properties and uses. So see here, what are the preparation methods of this Mg1? So preparation methods of Mg1, that is first one. Preparation methods, that is magnesium metal is on strong combustion, that is burning any. In oxygen, magnesium metal is burned in oxygen, that gives respect to magnesium oxide. Magnesium metal burned in oxygen gives magnesium oxide. It is the preparation method. Next, when magnesium hydroxide is on strong heating, gives magnesium oxide and water. Magnesium oxide and water. Next, when magnesium nitride, boys, just now we completed. Any nitride on heating gives respect to oxides and NO2 gas and O2 gas. Magnesium oxide is a product. Magnesium oxide. It's not out. Sulfate. When magnesium sulfate, MgSO4, is on heating gives respect to oxides. And SO2 and O2 are the products, boys. SO2 and O2. So these are all some preparation methods of magnesium oxide. Generally in laboratory. But in large scale preparation, generally magnesium oxide is prepared from magnesium carbonate. That is nothing but calcination. So see here. So mainly, this is the reaction, boys. CaCO3, sorry, not CaCO3, MgCO3. Which is called as magnesite. It is a ore of magnesium, boys. If this magnesite ore is calcinated means heating. In the absence of oxygen, boys. So heating in the presence of oxygen is called as combustion. Heating in the absence of oxygen is calcination, roasting, combustion, or one way. It is in the absence of oxygen, no oxygen is there, that carbon is going to dissociate it, that gives magnesium oxide and carbon dioxide. Magnesium oxide, that is the way to prepare magnesium oxide, boys. So it is the major preparation method. It is the major preparation method that is from magnesite. That is from magnesite, which is also called as calcinated magnesia. Calcinated magnesium. Okay. So this is magnesium oxide, boys. Calcinated, because after calcination it is coming out. Calcinated magnesia, which is called as calcinated magnesia, which is nothing but magnesium oxide. So now these are the preparation methods. Now what are the properties of this magnesium oxide? Properties. See here. Properties. First one. It is a lightweight powder, boys. It is a lightweight powder. Very, very lightweight. Next. Sparingly soluble in water. So that is second point. Sparingly soluble in water. Sparingly means very slightly. Very slightly soluble in water. Sparingly soluble in water. Next. Weak basic in nature. It is a weak basic in nature. So it acts as a weak base. It acts as a weak base. Next. When magnesium oxide is heated with carbon, that gives MgC to magnesium carbide and carbon monoxide is the productant. Magnesium carbide and carbon monoxide is the productant. Okay, so these are all some properties, boys. Some properties. Now, the one and only most important property is, see here, it is very, very, very important. So that is the properties. One more. I'm writing here. So that is the fifth property, boys. Fifth property. So when magnesium dissolved in, when magnesium oxide dissolved in solution of MgCl2, very, very important. Saturated solution of MgCl2 that gives MgCl2 or MgBr2 forming basic solvent. Example, see here, MgCl2 that is with 9 moles MgOH twice with 5 water molecules. So it is the example, boys. It is the basic salt. It is the basic salt. Very, very, very important. So this basic salt, listen carefully. This basic salt, so slowly becomes hardened. Becomes hardened. So that harder mass, this basic salt, so it behaves like a cement, going to be hardening. So that is very, very important. That cement is called as Sorel's cement. That Sorel's cement is used to fill the cavities, the gaps present in the teeth. So when we are going to take dental doctor, so to fill the cavities, white solid is placed in the cavity. That white solid is nothing but this material, boys. It is white solid, which is called as a Sorel's cement. That Sorel's cement, so slowly getting hard, almost as our teeth. That much hardness is possible. That cement is called as Sorel's cement. That is prepared like this. So that contains magnesium oxide and saturated solution of magnesium chloride. Magnesium oxide, MgO plus saturated solution of magnesium chloride. That combination gives a pasty material. That pasty material slowly hardened and used to fill the cavities, the gaps present in the teeth, damaged teeth. Okay, so this is about the most important property voice. It is a basic search voice. It is a basic search. So it has basic nature. Now, what are the uses of this magnesium oxide? Already one of the uses are completed voice. So first one, uses. Uses. So because it is weakly basic, it is a weak basic. So it is used to decrease the acidity in our body, that is antacid. So therefore, it is used as antacid. It is used as an antacid. Next point. That is, so boys, magnesium oxide has good conductivity towards heating. That is why used to make refractory materials. So that is a furnace walls and so as a refractory materials to construct the furnaces, boys, as a refractory materials. Okay, next, third one and most important one, magnesium oxide plus saturated solution of MgCl2, saturated solution of MgCl2. Okay, so is the salt sets into hard massing. The salt sets into hard mass, which is called as Sorrell's cementing. Sorrell's cement. Sorrell's cement. So Sorrell's cement. That Sorrell's cement used to fill the gaps in the teeth. So used to fill gaps in teeth. So use it to fill gaps in the teeth. And very, very, very important, boys. Very, very, very important. Number of times asked. So Sorrell's cement, it is a combination of magnesium oxide and saturated MgCl2. So a pasty material formed that slowly sets as a cement. So use it to fill the gaps. So that cement is called as Sorrell's cement. So this is the preparation, some of the properties and applications of uses of MgOne, magnesium oxide. Yes. MgCl2, 5MgO, yes, accepted boys. XH2O. Okay. So Sorrell's cement. Next compound, magnesium hydroxide. Second compound, magnesium hydroxide, MgOH twice. Twice. This magnesium hydroxide is available in our nature under the name as a mineral. Of brucite under the name brucite as a mineral. So see here, occurs in nature as mineral brucite, brucite. What is the formula? Magnesium hydroxide itself is the name formula for that planet. So under the name brucite, okay. So, but what is the preparation methods? It is the naturally available situation. Now preparation methods, boys. So preparation, which is collecting like this, and also prepared in our laboratory. That is when magnesium sulfate reacts with sodium hydroxide gives MgOH twice plus Na2SO4. MgOH twice plus Na2SO4. Okay, so it is one of the preparations. So it is maybe in the lab end. On large scale, so that is when magnesium chloride reacts with calcium hydroxide, that is called as magnesium hydroxide. Why is this magnesium hydroxide is insoluble and gives calcium chloride. So it is the industrial preparation method of magnesium hydroxide. Industrial preparation method of magnesium hydroxide. Now, what are the properties of this one? Properties. What is that property? First one, it is white powder wise. It is white powder. Once again, sparingly soluble in water. Sparingly soluble in water. Weak base. It acts as a weak base. So because it is base, dissolved in acids. Because it is a base, dissolved in acids. That means when magnesium hydroxide dissolved in acid like HCl, that gives magnesium chloride and H2O is the product. Magnesium chloride and H2O is the product. Like this. Because of this, this is dissolved in acid. Next. When magnesium hydroxide is on strong heating, MgOH twice is on strong heating up to 200 degrees centigrade twice. Gives respect to magnesium oxide and water. It is a way to prepare magnesium oxide just before we completed it. On heating gives magnesium oxide. On heating gives boys. Boys, so what are the uses? See here. Uses. The most important use is this magnesium hydroxide is sparingly soluble in water. Sparingly soluble in water. That means when MgOH twice is dissolved in water, so that is a suspension is formed, right? Which is soluble, a little soluble and almost insoluble. A suspension like material is formed. That suspension is called as milk of magnesia. So that suspension is called as milk of magnesia, which is used as an antacid to reduce the acidity in our stomach. Used as and that means suspension, very, very important. The suspension, its suspension in water is called milk of magnesia. Is called milk of magnesia. Very, very important. So suspension, MgOH twice, suspension solution is called as milk of magnesia and used as antacid. Next one, and important. In sugar industry, it is used. In sugar industry, so that is sugar crystals are separated from molasses. There, this magnesium chloride, magnesium hydroxide is used by so from molasses. So it is the preparation and most important uses and preparation and uses of magnesium hydroxide. Next compound boys, next third one. That is magnesium chloride. Most of the points we covered in our previous classes, just a little bit. Now, the compounds, what is that? Is this third one? Yes, third one. Magnesium chloride. Formula MgCl2 6H2O. MgCl2 6H2O. It is a magnesium chloride, boys. Magnesium chloride. So, what are the preparation methods? Magnesium chloride. Already we know that magnesium chloride is in combination with MgO that gives Sorrell's salt, use it to fill. That is the teeth cavity set. That is a, one of the uses of this chemical. Now, preparation properties. So, how to prepare this? This is the salt, boys. Acid plus base combination gives a salt. See here, in lab, preparation methods. In lab, first one, when magnesium reacts with, when magnesium metal, because it is active metal, boys, so this reacts with dilute acids, that gives magnesium chloride plus hydrogenic acid is evolved. Hydrogenic acid is evolved. Next, magnesium oxide, when reacts with acids, because we require chlorine, HCl is used, right? So that gives magnesium chloride plus H2O. Magnesium chloride plus H2O. Next, hydroxide. Magnesium hydroxide and reacts with acid, that gives magnesium chloride plus H2O. Magnesium chloride plus H2O. So these are the laboratory preparation methods of MgCl. Laboratory preparation methods of MgCl. But industrially, so on large scale, MgCl2 is prepared by fractional crystallization of carnallite. Why is, what is the formula for carnallite? So do you know carnallite? It is the ore of magnesium. There is magnesium adding. So what is that ore? What is the formula for carnallite? Carnallite is nothing but KCl MgCl2 6H2O. KCl MgCl2 6H2O. It is the carnallite. It is the mineral, boys. It is coming out from our earthquakes. By using this, we can prepare MgCl2 6H2O. Just that is fractional crystallization, boys. First of all, see here, what is the process? So take carnallite. Take carnallite. Carnallite is nothing but KCl MgCl2 6H2O. 6H2O. So heated strongly. Heated strongly. So all this solid is becomes molten mass. So all this solid, it is solid, boys. This solid totally converts into molten mass that contains KCl, MgCl. Now slowly cool. Slowly cool down. So cool to 449 Kelvin. So cool to, that means more than that we are heated it. So cool it to 449 Kelvin temperature. There the available KCl is going to be precipitated out, crystallized out. So that means KCl, it is a crystallized. But MgCl2 6H2O is in molten state. But MgCl2 6H2O is molten state. Separate this solid and this liquid separate it at that temperature. So that liquid contains MgCl2CH2O, that is 6H2O. So this liquid still cooled. That gives MgCl2 6H2O solid. This is the way to prepare MgCl2 6H2O. It is the industrial preparation method of MgCl2, boys. From carnallite, it is the way. Okay. So this is preparation methods. Now, what are the properties of this MgCl? Properties of MgCl2. See here. Properties, in particular heating, what is that? See here, for example, MgCl2 6H2O is heated strongly. I am trying to become, to convert that MgCl to anhydrous substance. Already we completed, boys. That is why I am writing once again. So MgCl2, 2H2O is there. Minus 4H2O, boys, here. Minus 4, 4 water molecules are easy to remove. But remaining 2 water molecules are not. This is water of crystallization. So it is still heated. This water reacts with this MgCl2 that gives magnesium hydroxide and HCl gas is coming out. If that is still heated, that is still heated, gives magnesium oxide plus H2O is the product. That means if hydrated magnesium sulfate is heated itself, finally we will get magnesium oxide, not anhydrous MgCl. Not anhydrous. But so to prepare anhydrous salt, it is only possible in the presence of dry HCl. So already yesterday we completed any. So that is in the presence of dry HCl, that is MgCl2, 6H2O is coming out. It is anhydrous salt. That means anhydrous magnesium chloride from hydrated magnesium chloride is possible only in the presence of dry HCl. Only in the presence of dry HCl. Okay, so it is important. Next, there is another way to prepare this anhydrous salt, boys. That is when magnesium oxide heated with carbon in the presence of chlorine, that gives MgCl2 plus carbon monoxide. It is anhydrous points. Anhydrous salt. It is anhydrous salt. It is the way to prepare anhydrous salt. So indirectly, not from hydrated salt. It is indirectly that anhydrous salt we can prepare it. Okay. Next, what are the uses of this MgCl2? Uses, boys. Already I explained in the beginning, that is magnesium oxide, saturated solution of MgCl2 sets as hard mass called as Sorel's cement, called as Sorel's cement, used to fill gaps in teeth, used to fill gaps, that is cavities. So this is the most important. It is the most important use of our MgCl2. MgCl2. So very, very, very important, boys. So very, very, very important. So this is magnesium chloride. Almost we covered, boys. Almost we covered. Just all those covering points collected at one point. Okay. Next compound. Third. That is fourth compound. Any magnesium sulfate. It is a little bit long. Any lengthy topic. That is magnesium sulfate. Little bit. Next, subheading. Magnesium sulfate. Boys, in our nature, this magnesium sulfate has a caserite, MgSO4H2O. So mineral is formed. So that is the most important core of this MgSO4. So that is caserite. So that is available in nature as caserite, K-I-E-S-E-R-I-T-E, caserite. What is its formula? That is MgSO4H2O, monohydrate. MgSO4, that is H2O. So it is a mineral, boys. It is a mineral form of MgSO4. It is the mineral form of MgSO4. Next, another form, Epsom salts. Also available, that is MgSO4-7H2O. MgSO4-7H2O. Boys, please keep in mind, whenever more than, that is odd number of water molecules are there in the hydrated salts. So, one of the water molecules is in hydrated bond, hydrogen bonding, and remaining water molecules are in coordinate covalent bond. See here, this is, we will rewrite it as Mg H2O 6 times SO4 H2O. So this water molecule, one water molecule with hydrogen bonding, these 6 water molecules with the coordinate covalent bonding. 6 water molecules are in coordinate covalent bond and one water molecule with hydrogen bond. Very, very important. Whenever odd number water molecules are there. So that last one is separated and remaining even number is going to be coordination complexes. It is in complex form. Okay. So that is Epsom salt, boys. MgSO4-7H2O. MgSO4-7H2O. Now, what is the preparation methods? No doubt that is collecting from like that, but in lab, this is magnesium and reacts with H2SO4, gives magnesium sulfate plus hydrogen gas. Next, magnesium oxide and reacts with H2SO4, gives magnesium sulfate plus H2O. Next, magnesium hydroxide and reacts with H2SO4, that gives MgSO4 plus 2 water molecules. Next, magnesium carbonate. So when reacts with HgSO4, gives magnesium sulfate plus CO2 plus H2O boys. So these are the preparation methods of MgSO4 in lab. Industrially, these are used. So in laboratory, these are the preparation methods. Okay. Now, properties. So this MgSO4, magnesium sulfate, this MgSO4 is a white solid. Okay. Soluble in water. Very, very important. Okay, now I am trying to heat an MgSO4-7H2O is heated up to 423 Kelvin. Very, very important, boys. Please keep in mind 423 Kelvin. So, 4 water, that is total 6 water molecules are coming out and minus 6H2O. That gives MgSO4-H2O is the productant. Still, it is heated up to 473 Kelvin. This remaining water molecule is also lost. That is a minus water. That gives MgSO4. It is anhydrous. Like this, MgCLT is not possible, boys. But MgSO4, it is possible. Still heated, that gives magnesium oxide, SO2 gas, and O2 gas is coming out. So that is the magnesium oxide, boys. So It is the action of heating. Very, very important. Next, it is also a fluorescent substance, boys. Here I am missing. This MgSO4 is efflorescent. Efflorescent means losses water of crystallization, becomes anhydrous salts. So that is efflorescent. Gains water from atmosphere, that is deliquescent or hygroscopic. But it is efflorescent, loses its water of crystallization and becomes anhydrous salt. So that is why it is MgSO4 is efflorescent substance. And next, with Na2CO3, this gives basic salt. See here. with Na2CO3 when MgSO4 reacts with Na2CO3 sodium carbonate gives plus water gives that is magnesium carbonate plus magnesium hydroxide magnesium carbonate plus magnesium hydroxide this is the compound so it is a basic salt boys that basic salt is coming out plus Na2SO4 plus H2 plus Na2SO4 plus this is CO2 is coming out balance it okay so it is called as basic magnesium carbonate this is called basic salt that is basic magnesium carbonate the name of that compound is basic magnesium carbonate it is the base boys it is magnesium bicarbonate magnesium carbonate it is called as basic magnesium carbonate it is a salt in case of if many magnesium bicarbonate is used instead of Na2CO3 NaHCO3 is used see here if NaHCO3 is used what is the reaction see here when MgSO4 reacts with 2 moles NaHCO3 that becomes bisulfate magnesium bisulfate magnesium bicarbonate that is with Na2SO4 twice it is heated gives magnesium carbonate plus H2O plus CO2 so that means if you want magnesium carbonate use bicarbonate if you want magnesium bicarbonate with magnesium hydroxide addition salt that is a basic salt use magnesium carbonate so magnesium carbonate if you use magnesium carbonate that gives basic salt is coming out including that is MgCO3 plus MgOH twice is the combination but if magnesium carbonate only along this if you want only sodium bicarbonate is used not used sodium carbonate so these are the most important conditions in magnesium sulfate most important conditions next what are the uses of this chemical and uses first one used as purgative what is the meaning of purgative boys purgative is nothing but so generally where it is that is vomiting sensation to control the vomiting sensation purgative and laxative means so digestion problem to control to solve the digestion problem so those medicines are used are called as laxatives so that's why here MgSO4 this MgSO4 is used as both purgative as well as laxative so vomiting to control vomiting sensation and to avoid digestion problem so that is laxative and purgative next one second one that is as a mordant in dyeing so that is in colors and next point in sizing of papers that is in the size of papers in the sizing of paper next very very important in making fireproof cloths in making fireproof cloths any next and very very important this one also that is platinized platinum coated MgSO4 is used as a catalyst in the synthesis of sulfuric acid by Grillo's process in Grillo's process there is one of the preparation methods of HgSO4 ra. There platinum chloride MgSO4 is used as a platinum chloride MgSO4 is used as a catalyst end. Very, very important. It is also important, boys. These two are very, very important. This one, ergative and laxative. So this is about MgSO4, magnesium sulfate. So MgSO4, 7H2O is called as, that is Epsom salt. Epsom salt. That is one of the minerals of MgSO4 and magnesium. Magnesium. Okay. So this is magnesium sulfate. Next one, magnesium carbonate. Already we prepared it. Magnesium carbonate. It is a preparation method, boys. So that's why I'm not rubbing that. Next compound. Fifth one, magnesium carbonate formula MgCO3, which is magnesite. Magnesite. MgCO3, which is also called as mineral, is called as magnesite. So it is MgCO3, boys. Okay. So it is in nature exists as magnesite in nature. In nature, magnesium carbonate exists as magnesite. Now, what is the preparation method? So this is the preparation methods, boys. How to prepare this magnesium carbonate? And magnesium sulfate is treated with sodium bicarbonate. First of all, bicarbonate is the product and then converts into carbonate after heating it. So it is the preparation of magnesium carbonate, boys. Magnesium carbonate. Now, what are the properties? Properties. So, properties. It is a white solid. It is a white solid. Sparingly soluble in water. Sparingly soluble in water. And its solubility increased in the presence of CO2. So when CO2 is added, automatically solubility increases, because acidic nature, when CO2 is added into the water, acidic nature increases. As acidic nature increases, it is basic compound, so automatically it is going to be dissolved. In the presence of CO2, its solubility increases. Its solubility increases. Okay. So next, uses. What are the uses of this one? So that is used in ceramics. Used in ceramics, fertilizers. Used in fertilizers as a refractory materials, because conductivity is more, as a refractory material and as an acidic flux, boys. Sorry, because it is base, it is basic flux end to remove acidic impurities. Acidic impurities in metallurgy. In metal, boys, MgO also used, boys. MgO also used as a basic flux. So it is the important applications of uses of magnesium carbonate. It is magnesium carbonate. And last compound, boys, simple reaction. Last one for today's class. See here. That is magnesium ammonium phosphate. Last compound. Sixth one, magnesium, ammonium, phosphate. Formula, magnesium has plus two states, aluminium, ammonium, not aluminium, it is NaH4 plus. Phosphate means PO4 3 minus N. It's cell balanced, therefore the formula is Mg NaH4
magnesium, ammonium, phosphate.
Okay, yes, 6H2O is also there. 6H2O is also there. See here. Magnesium, ammonium, phosphate. Boys, it is the only test to find out Mg plus 2 ions present in your given solvent. In qualitative analysis, in laboratory, to find out Mg plus 2 ions in your given salt, so it is the component, white precipitate is formed. So by using this, we can find out. So it is only the test for Mg plus 2 ions. It is the only test for Mg plus 2 ions in qualitative analysis. Now, what is the preparation method? Preparation method. That preparation method is, first take 6H2 also. Take that 6H2 also, okay? Now, preparation method said. That is, when MgCl2 reacts with disodium hydrogen phosphate, so that is to get ammonium, that is ammonium chloride with water, that gives the product end Mg NaH4 PO4 6H2O plus NaCl plus HClN. NaCl plus HCl. Okay. So this is our magnesium dihydrogen, magnesium ammonium phosphate. It is the preparation boys. So that means not only magnesium chloride, any magnesium salt when treated with disodium hydrogen phosphate in the presence of ammonium chloride. So this is the product. It is a white precipitate. A white precipitate is formed. The formation of white precipitate with these chemicals, no doubt that contains Mg plus 2 ion. No doubt. Okay, now properties. Properties. If the salt is heated, that is magnesium ammonium phosphate is heated, that gives magnesium pyrophosphate, Mg2P2O7. Magnesium pyrophosphate with evolution of ammonia and water. Magnesium pyrophosphate. It is a salt, boys. Magnesium salt. One of the magnesium salts. Magnesium pyrophosphate. So it is the only property, boys. So just for explaining this concept, this is the topic we consider. So any magnesium salt is identified in your laboratory by using this magnesium ammonium phosphate precipitate. So this is the only reaction. Next, use this. No doubt to identify magnesium ions. So used in the detection and estimation of among magnesium ions in the solution. Used in the detection and estimation of magnesium ions in the solution, this compound is used. So it is in qualitative analysis. So that is the end of magnesium salts.